guys, I'm Jenk and welcome to another Cool Cast. Today we're outside the amazing Young Actors Theatre, the home of both the acting school and the agency. Today, two of its super famous alumni are coming in to have a chat with us, Ella Purnell and Asa Butterfield. So, they're in there now. Let's go. We're on the stage at Young Actors Theatre with two of the most talented young actors working today.
Schedule I can look at?
11 a.m.
to Seattle.
Is that where you're from?
That's where I live.
Hey! Hey!
I know what I'm doing.
You have no idea.
How far can these things fly? Could this go, like, all the way to Seattle?
Well, are you ready to go home?
We need minds like yours, Ender. You'll be the finest commander we've ever trained.
Both you two started taking acting lessons here, so what's it like coming back?
Young Actors Theatre, I think, is always a special place. I think in both of our hearts. I first started coming here when I was 8.
Oh, wow.
So that's like 11 years ago now. And whilst it's sort of changed and it's gotten new equipment and an amazing seating arrangement, it's still always had the same kind of heart and soul. And it's everyone's really kind of... The team that work here are just so dedicated and so passionate. There's very few places like this around.
How important is it to take classes and put in the work when you're young?
I think, classes are very important, and having someone who can teach you, because I think a lot of acting can be taught, and you can learn things through, one, from reading, two, from having incredible teachers and people around you to watch and to learn from. But as well as that, I think just... Being on stage or being behind a camera or in front of a camera, you learn just through that and through your own experiences, and you learn what you're good at and what you're not so good at, and through that you can develop on those and just become a better actor.
Mm. Do you think it helps that you start at a young age?
Definitely. I think, one, as you get older, if you started young, then it's a lot quicker for the nerves and the pressure to lessen. Mm. Whereas if you went into acting when you were my age, then you've still got quite those sort of those fresh nerves and those ideas, and you're not really sure what to do or what's right. But when you've been doing it for a while, you know the routine.
Mm-hmm. Mm. It's like a big jump if you were to do it late.
Exactly. Yeah. I think. Like you say, I think a huge amount of work goes into acting, and a lot more than people sometimes realise. You know, you only really see the tip of the iceberg. You don't see the whole mound that's underneath it. And I think the reason that I actually did join YATI when I was 13 or 14 was because at that point I'd done 3 or 4 feature films, but I didn't yet feel like I'd had my training. You know, when you're younger, it's easier to act in a way because you just sort of follow your instinct. Everything's a lot more natural. But I felt like I wanted to do that training, and I came here, and the first performance that I did was a restoration comedy, which is extremely difficult. And Andrew really put me through my paces. He made me work so hard. You know, we had hours and hours and hours of rehearsal, and I think I learned the majority of my craft actually spending hours in this, you know, in this room here, learning how to move on stage, you know, how to ground yourself, how to project to the audience. I think, you know, if it wasn't for YATI, I think I'd be in a very different position.
And also, lots of people get nerves before auditions, so how do you, like, take over nerves?
Yeah, I think smiling and pretending you know what you're doing is 90% of the job done. I think, yeah, everybody has to develop their own ways of getting over nerves. There's hundreds of different techniques that you can look up, but the most important thing is just be confident, be friendly, be yourself, and remember that it's not the end of the world. Stay calm as much as you can. And if something does go wrong, the audience don't know unless you tell them. Unless you show it on your face that you've gone wrong, they have no idea. They haven't read the script, you know? So it's really just winging it a little bit. Winging it is good.
You must see a lot of scripts, and how do you decide which scripts to go with and which to not set?
I've got a great team around me who help me out a lot. Both my agents and my mum, who've ever since I started acting, they've read my scripts, and we all read them, and I really value their opinions probably more than anyone else. And you do read a lot of terrible scripts, and for every 5 or 6 terrible scripts you read, you get this little gem, which you just know when you read it. You're like, this is, whether it's the story or the character that you're looking at, it jumps at you.
What is it?
It's a wind-up figure, like a music box.
Who built him?
I would think a magician.
You see this? A keyhole in the shape of a heart.
Another mystery.
Those are the ones that you really feel passionate about.
Just like sticks out.
Yeah, exactly. And those are the ones you go for. And you give it your all.
Yeah, I think you should never have to force yourself to like a script. I think that if you're reading a script and you're not rushing to turn every page, and 2 days after you finish the script, if you're not still thinking about it, it's probably not the script for you. I think there's thousands and thousands upon thousands of scripts out there, and it really is about finding what's best for you. If you read the scripts and you can see yourself playing that role from the first page, then you know that that's something that you have to do. It's like a gut feeling you have to trust.
Can you do that for me? Best you stick together. If Brooke wants a pet, she should just get a dog. She's just trying to recreate Mindy in her own image.
And do you choose scripts that highlight your strengths, or do you go for new ones there?
That's a good question. I think it's a combination of the both. For me, I always want to sort of like try something new and play a villain or do a comedy. I don't know. I like it. I'm still pretty new to all this. I mean, I've been doing it for 10 years, but in comparison to where I could go and the things I've yet to do, there's so much I'm still yet to learn as an actor. So yeah. I like to keep my options open. I don't like to pigeonhole too much and look for something in particular and just see what comes to me and take it that way.
How do you prepare for scenes with objects that only become real, say, in post-production? There's a new world coming.
And it's just around
the bend. How did you?
It's my peculiarity. If I show you the rest, you have to promise not to run away.
Promise me one thing. Look after them, Jenk.
I promise. There's a
new world coming. How do we prepare? Specifically with this, and I think with any films, is being able to know sort of what it is you're going to be looking at. And so they have a lot of concept art and images which the directors would show you, just to give an idea of what's going on in their head, and you can try and get on the same level so that when you're visualizing it, you kind of know roughly what it's going
to
look like and what they want you to be seeing exactly. And having all that information is really useful, because it just makes, you have to think less, and the less you have to think, the easier the whole thing is.
What he said.
So you're obviously both very experienced and have worked with amazing directors. What's the best, most clever words of wisdom, say, that you've heard?
Cheers, Ace. I think every movie that you work on, you take away something new. I think every movie that you work on and every director that you work with shapes you in a different way. When I did a movie called Wildlike, and the director, just every time I did a take, he'd just say, do less, stop giving. Because especially in film, it's quite different on stage, where the camera's so close up that the tiniest movement screams so much emotion. So it really is about doing less and not overthinking it. But then when I worked on Miss Peregrine with Tim, everything was do more, I want more, you know? Because he's very much a very stylized way of acting. It all had to be like a little bit creepy, a little bit, you know, eerie. So it changes, you know, it changes with everyone that you work with.
Yeah. What's the one thing that young actors should always remember in auditions, so?
I think there's a couple of things. Firstly, is that it's not like the only role, it's not the only audition you're going to have. There will be more, and that you should try and not be be pressured into nailing it your first time, because everyone makes mistakes. You're going to learn from your mistakes, so don't be scared to mess up and pick yourself back up again.
When you do so much TV and you do so much film, would you like to do maybe theatre?
Absolutely, yeah. I'm dying to get into theatre. I really am. I think they're completely different experiences, completely different. Something I love about theatre, I really miss about theatre actually, is that the audience reaction is so live. You know, if you don't hit that punchline, the audience don't laugh, you know, it's right there, you know, and you just have to save face and carry on. You can't stop, you can't cut, you can't retake it, you know. Mm-hmm. And you're in this moment, you're with this character for 2.5 hours straight, you know. And you, for me personally, I get so involved into something. I get so emotionally attached to a character in a moment. I feel like every night is like an emotional roller coaster. Yeah, yeah, I'd love to get into theatre.
And you've been incredibly generous with your time. Best of luck with the new film. The trailers look amazing. And also, I heard that it was someone's birthday yesterday.
Oh. So, bless you. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Really Thank
sweet.
You.
Oh. Pleasure.
Thank you.
Love me.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you so much to Asa and Ella for all the amazing work they did with us. If you want to come to YATI, they've got amazing holiday courses and after-school classes. I've been to so many of them. They're so much fun. Make sure you come to Young Actors Theatre if you want to win one of these amazing Academy Awards. Thank you very much. Oh, yes, you too. Thank you. I want to thank my mother. Thank you very much. Thank you.